Shafiqur Rahman sir, Varun Pathak sir, Gitesh Kaushik, Elena Dill ma'am, and Malavika Kalita ma'am on the dais. Thank you. May I now request our invited guest, Varun Pathak, Director, World for Education, sir.
Photo
Thank you,
ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. It's an honor if we have a good opportunity to this power of youth, our energy with us. Basically, you are the ambassador of the peace or the social issues. That's why we are here. I can speak in Hindi if you can understand. बहुत बड़ा इशू ब्राइट ट्रैफिकिंग और जो सेक्स रेशियो है मेल और फीमेल का स्पेशली इन सेंट्रल इंडिया नॉर्थ इंडिया जो भी डेवलप्ड स्टेट है दिल्ली पंजाब हरियाणा बहुत बड़े लेवल पर हो रहा है और नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया के बहुत बड़े पार्ट से जो ब्राइट ट्रैफिकिंग का इशू है वो डे बाई डे इंक्रीज हो रहा है और लगातार जो भी हम हरियाणा पंजाब दिल्ली ये इस रीजन में जब भी रेस्क्यू हो रहा है तो मैक्सिमम विक्टिम फ्रॉम द नॉर्थ ईस्ट मेघालय आसाम एंड अदर स्टेट वेस्ट बंगाल सो इस पूरे प्रोसेस को और जो लास्ट सेंसस 2011 का है उसको देखने के बाद वी आइडेंटिफाई के मार्च आसाम टू और मेघालय टू शिमला इट्स अराउंड 8000 किलोमीटर मार्च specific for the bride trafficking or of course it's the main human trafficking issue in India and we cover around more than 50 state district in 11 state और इस पूरे process में एक network बनाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं हम सब लोग within the government department इसमें DLSA है DCPU है और NCPCR नेशनल कमीशन प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ चाइल्ड राइट्स एंड ऑल स्टेट चाइल्ड राइट्स कमीशन इस पूरे प्रोसेस के अंदर इन्वॉल्व है और इस पूरे ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेस एक हेल्पलाइन नंबर हम लोगों ने स्टार्ट किया है जो नेशनल नेटवर्क को जोड़ेगा सोर्स और डेस्टिनेशन एरिया को और वो नंबर जो है वो 24 आवर्स काम करेगा उसने फोर लैंग्वेजेस में उसको शुरू किया है आसाम वेस्ट बंगाल आसाम बंगाली इंग्लिश एंड हिंदी और इसमें कभी भी किसी भी लैंग्वेज में आप लोग हेल्प कर सकते हैं कोई भी केस या इश्यू आप लोग शेयर कर सकते हैं जहां भी इस तरह की इंफॉर्मेशन आपके पास है जब लोग आप एजुकेशन के बाद अपने फील्ड या सेक्टर में निकलेंगे तो मे भी कुछ लोग एजुकेशन में काम कर रहे होंगे कुछ लोग शायद हेल्प पर हो बड़ी एमएलसी में हो कंपनी में हो गवर्नमेंट जॉब में हो या कुछ लोग हो सकता है कि एक्टिविस्ट मोड में आए और शायद विमेन या चाइल्ड प्रोटेक्शन के इश्यूज पर काम करें तो उन सारी इश्यूज को जब आप देखेंगे और आप समझेंगे तो बहुत एक कहने में शायद बहुत छोटा सा वर्ड है कि ब्राइट ट्रैफिकिंग मगर एक्चुअली उसके बाद जो उनकी लाइफ यहां से जाने के बाद चेंज होती है और शायद 90% के आसपास विक्टिम होते हैं जो अपनी फैमिली को दोबारा कांटेक्ट नहीं कर पाते हैं एज ए स्लेव पूरी लाइफ उसके बाद उनके आगे होती है वो हर एग्रीकल्चर जो पेट एनिमल है उन सब को उनको देखना और उसके बाद ना सोसाइटी में वो स्टेटस है ना ही वो फैमिली या सोसाइटी को रिकॉग्नाइज करती है उसमें निश्चित बात और ना ही उनकी फैमिली यहाँ से वहां देख सकती है ना वो वापस अपनी फैमिली में आ सकते हैं तो वो जो पूरा एक नेटवर्क है जो सिचुएशन एक बनी हुई है एक तरफ हम women empowerment की बात कर रहे हैं अभी that's in Hindi religion अभी 9 days दुर्गा अष्टमी और पूजा हुई है और एक तरफ दूसरी तरफ women के साथ इस तरह के सारे issues हो रहे हैं तो उन सबको link करते हुए government की जितनी भी scheme है including Supreme Court Khalsa की जो trafficking victim की scheme है उन सबको link करते हुए हम एक network बनाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं और ये पूरे process में हम स्पेशली जो रूरल बैंक है ऑफ कोर्स यूनिवर्सिटीज को हम लोग कवर कर रहे हैं इस पूरे कंपेनिंग में मगर स्पेसिफिक वो रूरल एरिया वो और ट्राइबल बैंक और वो लोग जो जिनके अंदर फेयर है पुलिस स्टेशन जाने का रिपोर्टिंग करने का कंप्लेन करने का उन सब लोगों को हम जाकर इंटीरियर पे जाकर टच कर रहे हैं और वी होप के अभी बहुत सारे केसेस और इन्फॉर्मेशन हमारे पास आई है इस तरह की केसेस की We hope के during 2 months के पूरे process में हमारे पास more than 5,000 के आसपास cases होंगे, जिसको हम government of India के साथ share करेंगे और कुछ ना कुछ solution इस सारी चीजों पे निकालेंगे। मैं आगे invite करूँगा कि Mr. Shafiqur Rahman को कि वो कुछ आए और बाकी चीजों पर थोड़ा सा। Thank you.
Thank you so much for having me here. Thank you, Varunji, for inviting me on podium. Thank you, Aminul, sir, for inviting me in this university. And thank you, my friends, comrades, for coming here with me. We are marching from Karbi Along district, a district of Assam, towards Shimla of Himachal Pradesh. And we have a singular agenda to make awareness about bribe trafficking. What bribe trafficking was actually imported from Korea. And it is still not a recognized cause. So we are establishing this cause as a cause because most of the people justify this practice by this way or that way. The major thing is like what the major question is actually. Like, what is bribe trafficking? That is a major question of anyone. And even if you are thinking about a whole process, you must have this in your mind. So, bribe trafficking is trafficking of a minor for the purpose of forced marriage. So, it's a cause about forced marriage. It's a cause about my child marriage, minor marriage, and it's a cause of trafficking. So it's a kind of cocktail. Everything is here and no one actually cares about it. So this march was designed to connect the dots in almost 50 districts of different state. That is 10 states, Assam, West Bengal, Jharkhand, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Delhi, Haryana, Punjab, Himachal Pradesh. So, and this route is known for, this route is used by trafficker for trafficking more than 60% of total trafficking happening in this country. And this is not only about in-house trafficking, within country trafficking, but it is also being used for cross-border trafficking. You know the problem of Bangladesh and Myanmar and Nepal. So this route is being used for trafficking those girls too. And no one actually care about the trafficking of those girls and boys. Every year, NCRB reports like they are rescuing 10,000, 12,000, 50,000 girls from different kind of trafficking, but India have no trafficking helpline. We have only one helpline kind of thing, and that is childline 1098. So you can only report minor cases there. So we decided to launch a number for the purpose of addressing trafficking issues, and we are here propagating that number. So now our I should have known, but you know, I'm a confused person. So okay. So now I would like to share why trafficking is particularly bright trafficking is bad for people, because most of people have aspiration to migrate. You all are in a university, and you must come from some other small towns or some other places for good, and that is called migration for good. So some poor girls migrate some other place for purpose of marriage, and they think that is good, migration for good. So is it like trafficking? If I am using what trafficking, that is really technical, and you cannot say directly trafficking to any migration. So let's call it migration. If this is a marriage migration, then why we are offended and why we want to stop it? Because in most of case, our mothers were from some other places and they migrated to our father's place and staying here. So how can we call it trafficking? If this is trafficking, then we all are children of trafficking victims or survivors. So no, bright trafficking is pure trafficking. It is not about bride or marriage. It's simply about they are naming institution of marriage and trafficking girls in the name of marriage. But that is typical case of trafficking. Girls are being transported with involvement of, this is UN protocol, okay? So, girls are being trafficked with what? I mean, with the help of a third person, with involvement of money, and there is exploitation waiting for them. So, this is a typical trafficking. The girls are going there, living in a slavery or slavery-like condition and surviving their life. But before you call it slavery, you must know that modern day slavery is little sophisticated. People not needs to be in chain for being enslaved. Your mind is captured psychologically. If we have some psychology, some students from psychology, yeah. Okay. So, if you are chained psychologically, you cannot complain, you cannot say anything, then you are almost enslaved. So, this is typical that type of case. I would like to share a few examples. Around 5 or 6 years ago, we went to rescue a girl. We went there with the police, and the man who purchased that woman showed us a document, a notary document. You know, 100 rupees or 200 rupees.
Affidavit.
A stamp paper, sorry. So, he showed our a stamp paper and said, like, I have purchased this girl for 60,000 rupees. Okay? That is poor document. And police wala was saying, sir, he gave 50-60,000 rupees for God, so how can we rescue? And the man was fighting that if you want to bring back this girl, then you have to pay my money. And police wala was supporting her. Mm-hmm. And I was shocked. So then I said, okay, invite him in a police session and ask him to argue this before the police and magistrate. That's all. So the man was speaking against him in the court and he was convicted, of course. So this type of normalization of slavery and buying and selling human beings is being practiced everywhere, almost everywhere. And in another case, in a district of Barpeta, there is a police station, Baghbur police station. And ASI sent me a message, said, sir, there is a girl who was trafficked and she is living in somewhere in North India. So can you please find her? And we traced her. And when we contacted the family and asked the family that we are ready for rescue and tell me if you are ready to accept her in the family. And family said, where is she? So I thought, okay, this is just, because they have lost their daughter and there is a 6-month separation, so they are keen to know about their daughter. And when we shared all details with them, she said, the mother of the girl said, no, we don't want her to back in my home because I have other daughters too. And it was the girl who decided to go there. She was adult and this and that. But she fell in love with some boy. She went to Delhi. And she ran away, she loved, and she went to Delhi, and she was expecting a good life there, but the man sold her into drug trafficking, and the girl had no option to come back, and even her family was not willing to accept her. So this is complexity of this cause. This is complexity of this cause because, you know, most of the family members do not accept their children because there is a AV called honor, family honor. Because they think that if girl will come back, then she will bring shame over the family. And this is the real problem. The real culprit is not trafficker, let me say. The real problem is not trafficker. The real problem is not buyer. The real problem is our parents. Because if I am a man, and if I have daughter, and if daughter is not willing to share anything, or if she is afraid of saying anything to me, this is my failure. So we must know and we must convince our parents that they should be cool parents. No? They should accommodate our aspiration. They should accommodate our new ideas. Maybe. Why girl run away with some unknown people? Why? Just because they know my parents will say no, and not only say no, but also they will beat us, beat me, or stop me from going outside from home. And there are a lot of issues. And even sisters will tease me, and brothers will abuse me for anyone. But love. love is actually normal thing, but parents are not willing to accommodate their feelings. And most of the time, you all are young people, and I am not, I know that. So, most of the time, we fall for something, especially in relationship. At least with me, it was common. Not was, is common. So, but after a time, everything fed up from memories and feelings and everything. So this is simple kind of thing, like something is touching us and then away. That's it. That's finished. No one can, okay, I am not a girl, but still, assume, you can simply assume that, okay, I am a girl, so no one can traffic me. Why? Just because I have a peer group, I have a parent who used to accommodate my ideas, my feelings. When empowered people, I have to share about empowered people. That is fantastic story, and you all will love that. So when we started empowered people, everyone was almost against us. I am from Bihar, and my education was in Delhi, and I was living there in Delhi. So when we started this empower people, we launched the march against female feticide in Haryana. We were doing a march, and we met a girl who was from my nearby district native, that is Hazaribagh, that is in Jharkhand now. So, and she shares her story and said that we are enslaved, and we are living pathetic life, and I have to be in physical relationship with all members of the family where I am living. So why don't you people work for us? And then we started the hunt for a search for her after a month, because at that time I was suggested that we should not touch this issue, because our march will be Wednesday. Like, for now we are marching against blood trafficking. And imagine if I will encounter some new kind of thing, and I will try to jump on that, my friends will stop me and say, like, finish this fast, and then go there. So we were marching against female feticide, male blood trafficking survival, and then my friends stopped me intervening in that case. And then after 2 months, I realized that I have to do something for that girl, and then we have started this organization. So we are still in search of that girl, and this march against bride trafficking 2018. Yeah, 18 now. So 18 is dedicated to her only. We want to find at least 5,000 missing cases from all these areas. And we will submit all those cases before Supreme Court and ask them to create a mechanism for for finding and making things possible before the Supreme Court. Bride trafficking is really complex issue, and our story is more than fanatical story. We have less time, and I have to stop speaking before people ask me to stop. So this is it, and I want you all to visit our website, learn more about cases, and make people aware in your native areas, your native places, so we can save at least one life. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Malavika Polita, your neighbor. I am the district child protection officer of Kamrup district. And I'm really, really grateful to empower people for making me a part of this march. March against bribery. So everything is already spoken. You all have learned many things. So I don't have actually anything to speak, but just entering here, I saw one line and I want to repeat that line with you. That's why I came here. The line was, the struggle you feel today will bring the strength we need tomorrow. And you might be thinking that we will not, because we are empowered, with education, we won't be the prey for the traffickers. None of our family members will be. Or the boys also will think that we won't traffic any girl. But being a student of social work department, the strength that brings for tomorrow is not only for us, not only for our degree, but for the society. And to bring a strong society, to make a strong society, we have to work for the society. And I request all of you to, as they say, to go through their website, to use their, they have launched one helpline number. I also would like to request you to use the Childline helpline number, it is 1098-1098. If you see any child in distress, you can use that number 1098. And if you see any kind of girl trafficking, any kind of trafficking for marriage, bride trafficking, then you can use their helpline number. Nothing else. Thank you very much. And yes, I'm really very sorry. It's because of me. I